God said, I know you're waiting for Mashiach for a long time. Don't lose your patience. Even if he disappointed you so far, even if he's getting delayed, hitma'amea, chakelo, kivo yavo lo yeacher. He will come, I promise. He will not be late. It looks like that he's late. When he come, everybody will understand that he was in the perfect timing. You know how it is, sometimes you think, the plane, the bus, it delay, but when you land, then you realize what you got saved from. All kinds of things like this. And then you say, well, really, it was no delay. It was supposed to be like this, and that's the best way. Ve'tzadik be'emunato ichye. Now, what does it mean, tzadik be'emunato ichye? Many people in Israel, they say, ish be'emunato ichye. Rabbi, leave me alone. Let everyone live according to his belief. You do what you want and let me do what I want, right? Ish be'emunato ichye. But they don't know that the Torah never say ish be'emunato ichye. The Torah say tzadik be'emunato ichye. Only a righteous person would live forever thanks to his emunah that made him tzadik. The Torah continue, many of us has a problem believing that there will be one day Tchiyat HaMetim, the resurrection of the dead. We know according to the Nevuot, one day the Mashiach will come, and after the Mashiach it will be time that all the people, all the righteous Jews that died in the past will all come back to life. Even those who are dead for 2,000 years, 3,000 years, 500 years, doesn't matter, all the bones will connect and the ligaments and the flesh and the skin will all come back and the soul will enter the body and the person would rise from his grave. It sounds like, you know, Alibaba and his stories, right? But it already happened. It's already happened once in history when, listen good, Hashem came to Prophet Yechezkel and he said to him, and this is what he said, and the hand of God was on me, and he took me with his spirit and put me in a valley full of bones, full of bones. Ve'avirani aleim saviv saviv. He made me go in circle around all the bones. There's many, many bones in the desert. And the bones are very dry. You know how dry the bones? If it's dry, you can snap it in a second. It's hundreds of years old. This is the tribe of Ephraim who left Egypt before Moshe. They went before and they all got killed. So we are talking now about 700-800 years after they're dead. Now Hashem asked the prophet to bring them back to life. It's in the Tanakh. I want you to know that the Gemara brings a list in Masechet Sanhedrin who are the Jews that, God forbid, have no share to the world to come. One of them is a person who say, I don't believe that the dead will rise from the grave. Lo ma'amin b'tchiyat ha-metim. I don't believe in it. I'm realistic, Rabbi. I believe in Shabbat, Tefillin, no problem. But I don't believe in the resurrection of the dead. So, that's why we have it in the Tanakh. And Hashem said to him, do you think that these bones can come to life? And I say, Hashem, you know. And Hashem told him, start saying your prophecy. And the skin started to come, and all the pieces of the body started to grow back. And what happened? These people got up, and there was big noise, thousands of people, and noise. Everyone shake the sand from their body. And they get up, and they don't understand what happened. They were dead for 800 years. For exactly 800 years. But when Hashem said to the prophet Yechezkel, tell me, do you believe that these bones can come back to life? And the prophet Yechezkel answered, Hashem, you know. We would say right away, of course, Hashem, they can all come back. But prophet Yechezkel told Hashem, you know who can get up and who not. Depend who is a tzaddik and who is not. Only the tzaddikim get up.